Hello, ladies and gentlemen. So today we're going to do an analysis of a social dancing of two amazing dancers. So here they are. I'm talking about Oliver Pineda, who won many times the World Salsa Championship in partner work and also in solo. He's Australian. He's a very, very good dancer. And also Anita Santos Rubin, which is amazing also, who won many times championships with her partner Adrian. And I mean, these two dancers are very clean dancers, very, very good. I mean, in all fields of salsa dancing. And the idea for today is to analyze what makes them look great, you know, here. So let's start with the video, right? And then I'm gonna play pause and comment everything. Let's go. So first thing, you know, what very, very good dancers usually do when the music starts is that they don't run that much, that fast, you know, in every direction. Like, of course, for example, here Oliver knows that his dancer is very good, his partner is very good. He could start with many turns and everything, but he's not doing this. He's just waiting. He's just doing his alternating steps. And They just testing they connection each other and a little bit playing around, and now he's starting to turn around her, and then she let him doing this, not moving very far. So very interesting start, very slow start. So, as I was saying just before, you see, he respected her a lot. He make a turn around her. He check his chest, you know, by connecting to her, just testing the connection. She gives her hand in order to have connection, but with the other right hand arm, Anita was still doing styling. And of course, they respect steps, you know, 1, 2, 3, jack of 5, 6, 7. They're in the place, but it's like not something that beginners could notice, but as they are really, really professional, they could start from a crossbody lead at any moment, you know, they're ready. They are really ready. And finally, he tries a bit of pachanga, and then he feels the moment is gonna come, then because the music gonna change, you know, just put bit before. Music is changing a little bit. He knows it triggers another moment. He knows that's the moment to grab her and start with the crossbody lead. So can you hear this? Boom, 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 boom. There is bass in behind and on the background. He knows that something new is gonna start. So he's doing turn. She's doing also right turns because it's the shine for ladies, you know. So they're ready to start. Okay, this part I like very much. So he's starting with the nice combos, very fluid, no problem with this. Let's analyze what he's doing just there. As you can see, he just finished his turn from here. You know, he's finishing his turn very sharp, and then he maintained his arm, his hands, and he's watching what she's gonna do next. Like if he was doing something and then he's waiting for the answer. So he gives her space. That's really nice. Normally, you know, average dancers would turn and then boom, give a kind of a basic back, you know, can sometimes a bit strong with a, an extra, move from the arms that is useless. And he's just not doing this. He just gives space to the lady. And guess what? She's taking it. So let's do it again. And she's doing just something easy, just a nice basic. So for her, it means that she has a lot of, she's really, it's really comfortable for her to dance with him. Two things here. First, this module for girls, many girls, when I beginners, they don't understand that they have to go forward and to, you know, even when the guy is not in front of you, girls, you have to continue to go forward and then to go backward. Of course, there is one move of hip when you cross one leg in front of another, but you don't turn your body, right? So it's just there. And this module is important for the lady. Yes, there. And there is a very nice thing. There is a moment of chum, pokum, there's kind of break, and he could show off doing something great. He's just taking the option of doing something easy, just connecting his chest to her back and just bring a kind of wave. Very easy, but very, that works very good. You know, it's just enough. All right, very nice part here. So, remember, there is the break. Just after, she's doing one, two things, and then he turns and he let her end, and he starts with shines. And when he does this, he does it very clearly. It means that he doesn't let the choice to the lady to doubt if it's gonna be shine or if it's gonna be, you know, not really shines, but maybe a couple in a minute or something. No, because he's turning a lot. He's taking enough distance he's putting enough distance between him and her. So she doesn't have doubts about this. So she has space, and she's not like before, just doing a right turn or something. She's changing the angle of his position, and she's starting to do very nice styling. So for a moment, for a minute, I mean for 10 seconds, I guess, he's on his own and she's on her own. And that is important in salsa solo, you know? We have time to connect it and we have time disconnected. That is also good. So let's see this again, you know? Even before here. Yeah? Okay, so in the end, of course, she is still ready when it's the moment for him to grab her. So you can notice, guys and girls, that the way he arrives, I mean, in diagonal. He's not going front because it's like too intrusive, disturbing, I would say. He's coming, boo, you know, with an opening angle that is more comfortable for the lady to be catched for a crossbody lead there. So let's continue. So he did something very funny. I mean, he wanted to do something special. He almost broke the alternating steps, but finally he doesn't, because he's cheating on his steps, but the lady doesn't. And when he starts back, for the lady, it hasn't changed anything. So for the lady, it's always, he's always respectful of the steps of the lady. That's really good. And, let's see a little bit before. Okay, many things here again. I mean, you can notice that for great dancers, that's also the purpose of this program, is to understand that the mastering spinning helps a lot in partner work. So you can see here, I think it's there. He's spinning very fast, zoom. And when he lands, he's not doing something special, except like a little circle in the hips, like sensual move, you know, I'm the guy just in front of the lady, so guess what, it's your turn to move, you know, something like this. He's, in a way, in psychology, we could say, okay, he's blocking the way to go, and at that time, she expressed probably sensuality, we don't see that too much, but actually, it's also interesting because he doesn't need to do something special after this kind of break, you know? If you do a break and nothing behind, it's meaningful. If you break and something just after, we don't listen the break, you know what I mean? So listen again. Shon. All right. All right, so there is like just for fun. You can feel that, you know, we are almost in the middle of the song. The level of the part of the energy is growing more or less. There is a nice crossbody 36 degrees. You see, that's great. You can see that when he leads the left turn, you know, he turns totally his body, and then he with the energy of the body, he helps her to turn. He's playing with the little hands, so there is kind of game in the dance, but the energy is growing. Okay, nice thing about the preparation. You can see that Anita is doing very nice preparations, like 5, 6, 7. She brings she's stressing the 7 all the time, because on the 7 you have the ending of the preparation of turns. And what is interesting for him also is like the little circle for preparation is not too big. I've done this many times with Anita, with friend, and she told me, like, for example, for Yamule, there is a very nice stopping with the hand, with the right hand, when the guys are doing the circle, like, zhung. You know, it's important to stop the lady very nice in order she can end and finish her preparation. And Oliver is doing this very well and very short, you know, very short move. Very short move is enough to prepare the lady, okay? Because what counts is the fact the lady is turning her body more that the circle is big. So just let's see just before. And okay, so check the preparation. Ah, all right, a little preparation. Okay, nice moment for the ladies. You can see here that Oliver is just staying in the place, and with the elasticity of the moves, he lets Anita going far away. And you know, instead of just going on one line, Anita is using his leading side. That's why on the picture, just right here, she's opening her right side for the basic back. So that's really important, because it's this kind of opening that brings her a move circular, and that's gonna help her to come back fast, you know? So that's really important. All right, here we're really half of song. Let's say that's the great level of the energy. What I love in dance, in couple dance, especially in salsa, is that there is a lot of solo and of course a lot of connection in couple. There is a kind of rule, like grammar, you know, in dance couple. It's like the guy suggests something and the lady answers. And Oliver is suggesting the energy that is growing in the music. So remember, in the beginning, you know, it's like two person that meet each other. They don't know so much. They don't know to say things, you know, They shouldn't, so they try with the little words, and then it's growing. And now she has a lot of confidence in the dance because he let him the space and he's leading properly. So now he's tempting new things, you know? I mean, like crossbody 360 degrees, that is really challenging. And you know, as she feels confident, she adds some stuff really interesting in her dance, like the little cambray, you know, the little cambray on the crossbody lead. So that's because of faith with the partner. So look at that. There. You know, for example, she would never have done this, for example, with the beginner or with a guy which is not a very very good dancer, and all, of course not never in the beginning of the song, you know. So I love this part because there is nothing and there is a lot. Of course, there is a break, jigga jigga jigga, boom. Again, easy break. It's not, at least you can don't have many choice when you have two hands, you know, just linked with the other one. So he makes the choice just to bounce like boom, to, you know, to bring some break, and he's testing the frame from right to left. And for all this period, really interesting, she's playing with him with the eyes. They are really connected from one eye to the other. And so she's wondering, okay, is he gonna let me go or not? I mean, what's going on here? There's great intelligence here for both partners with the fact they play just doing basics. All right, just a little detail here for men's style. It's really, really detailed, but it brings many things. You know, when he comes here, just in front of the lady, he just put his arm just up to the head, and he looks at his hand just to pass him to pass this through. And does he really needs to look at his hand? Not that much, but it just gives meaning to the movement. So he's doing it many times, and it's really nice. So let's see it again. You know, just from here and right now. I hope you noticed it, and. So he did it again now, just he put his arm in the air and just he check in the air just to manage this. All right, very nice crossbody 360 degrees. Let's talk about this later. Okay, nice moment for the lady here. She's doing basic back just before open break. And you know, I guess you know this, open break is like when both of the dancers are doing a basic back, so that brings elasticity, and 5-6, you know, she lands on 6, so she opens on 6 again, her leading side on the right, in order to have power, to come fast, and to land on 1. Let's see this moment again. So now, you see, now she's opening the hips. Many, many girls, you know, they don't go enough on, they don't put their weight totally on the right side. For the ladies, that's why they don't have enough elasticity. And she opens the arm just after and then comes back really faster because of this. Okay. Oh yeah, that's great. So, damn, Anita is a very amazing dancer. She respects the lines. She makes the difference, for example, between when the guy put the hands in the air and when the guy turns his body. When the guy turns his body, it's connection. It makes her turn too. But if we just put the arm in the air, she doesn't affect, it doesn't affect, the way she has to go. That's why she continues going forward, and it enables Oliver to go back. So let's see that. Oh, sorry, I have a problem there. Yeah. Okay, so she continues forward like we saw before. Really important for the ladies, you know, when you feel the guy is behind you, continue your steps normally. If you try to anticipate this, you hinder the guy to achieve what he has in his mind, right? Okay, that's nice. So look, the position of Oliver. He has just the frame on the right side, and also he maintains the hand of the lady, but he doesn't lead her at all. He's just maintaining his steps, poco toco boom, back tiki boom, chaka chaka boom, and Anita just have the right side, you know, for her, and she's doing a lot of stylings like boo 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 ba, you know, putting his hands here on the chest, around the head, on the right side, everywhere. Look at that. That's a really nice moment of lady styling. Now. Okay, so that's nice, you know. She you know, I know many ladies, for example, in Paris, or anyway, that would have done something else, you know, that would went far away or tried to do too many things. Anita is very, is like many, many good dancers. What is good for lady styling is like to do little lady styling. That, because in partner work, we don't want the lady that disturbs the dance, you know. We want lady stylings that is, I don't know how to say that, but that it's not too big, that doesn't affect the quality of the connection with the partner. But it's the same for the guy, more or less, right? And look at this. She's doing the same as Oliver before. She's just looking at her hands when they are in the air, and it brings also sensuality and a lot kind of lady style. Just there. All right, so there, something also interesting for both sides, on Oliver's side and also for Anita. You know, as the level of the energy is still growing, you have Oliver that is once, he's doing a huge 360 degrees. So what is he doing? He grabs the floor. He's grounding a lot, he bends the knees, you know, he takes the floor. And Anita also, when she lands after the crossbody lead, she's doing an open brace like 5, 6, 7. She bends a lot, and it brings her attitude. Now, so she can add body moves at that moment, you know. All right, you notice here, very nice preparation in the end of the combination. Like da-ga-da-ga-da, brrrah. The circle is very clear, very easy to understand, so she cannot make confusion between this or another leading. Nice moment also. Here, he leads something for the lady, she turns, she has the hand in the back, and I know many ladies who, at the moment, she has the hands free, you know, she releases it very fast, and she starts doing lady styling and everything, and on the other side, the guy cannot find it back when he requires it. So, there is very good balance in the couple, because, of course, you know, if it lasts 2 seconds, it's too long, so the guy has to turn very, very fast in order that the lady doesn't have to wonder if it has to be maintained in the back or not. So that's, you can see that Oliver's is turning very fast here. Ha. All right. But also there is a lot of big intelligence here for on Anita's side. She's so aware, you know, she has a lot of awareness of what is going on. And in general, ladies, you have to remember this. when you are doing shines or when you are doing, especially about shines, you have to be always with kind of awareness, in alert, to see, okay, am I supposed to be ready to go back in partner work? Or if it's a moment I have 100% attention for myself from doing my shines. Let's say just a comparison. It's like a little animal, you know, that in the jungle who is afraid, for example, to be eaten by another one. You know, he's always waiting for what's going to happen. So it's great awareness that the lady has to get in order to check if it's the moment to shine, if it's the moment to be with the guys, the moment to let the hand in the back, right? Okay, let's continue. So, okay, they had a nice moment of shines. I'm not going to comment that one because more or less the same as before. They have space, they use it. So now we can listen, we can hear that it's the end of the song. You know, the coda is coming, so we can check this. So let's see what's going to happen. All right. It seems easy when you look at it, right? But it's not that difficult. But as we know that the music is gonna end. But how many social dancers, you know, they feel that it's gonna end like 2, 3, 4, 8 after, but they don't know exactly what to do. And you know, finally, they don't end on the gong, you know. And Oliver is really amazing for this. So. He's just like measuring, you know, anticipating how long it's gonna last, so how many things he can put in order to just land on time. So that's like just mastering. That is a really professional thing. Another detail about the styling here, when he land the lady to turn, he's not landing the landing. He's not sending the lady with an arm who is moving so much. No, he's just finishing his movement in order that the movement is really clean. Let me show you where it is again. It's just there. So turns. And now you see that he brings his back, the elbow is blocked, and there is not extra movement that would have been useless at that time. So in the end, he grabs her with the right hand in the back, and then she feels that she has she understands at that moment that she has to be in cambré position or closed position. Sorry. Yeah. So that's the end. All right. So that's about 500,000 views, you know, on YouTube. That's normal because very, very professional interaction of two amazing dancers. So, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you liked this kind of analysis, and tell me which other dancer you would like me to comment, right? Okay, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. See you. Bye-bye.